Hi, this is Teddy from Switzerland with another knife review, and today we're going to take a look at a very, very special full custom knife built by Thierry Savidan out of France. And he is one of these higher tier, very well-known French knife makers like Philippe Georget, GTK Knives, Rémi Lavial, just not on the hype level that, for example, a David Lespect is at. And he's also a very, very talented knife maker. This is in the knife making game for a long time. I believe he started making knives in 2005, and he has a lot of different knife models. He has front flippers, regular flippers, lots of different designs available. And he just came out with another very interesting front flipper design iteration that is called the Zen. But the knife we are talking about today is this one right here. This is my Thierry Savidan Arcos. So this is the second kind of popular front flipper that he has designed. The first one was the Xerox, which is very similar in its overall styling, but there are a bunch of different changes and differences to the Xerox here on the Arcos that made me choose actually this one, namely, for example, the blade, this special area right here, the way the front flipper is executed, and some other things as well, like the pocket clip. But we're going to do some more detailed views on the knives a little bit later on. So this is the Arcos, and because it's a custom knife, we will start off with the specifications and then go further down the road. So the Thierry Savidan Arcos right here has an overall length of 7.48 inches or about 19 centimeters with a blade length of 3.34 inches or 8.5 centimeters. A pretty stout blade stock of 4 millimeters right there. The steel on my particular model is RWL34 at around 59 to 61 Rockwell hardness. Then we get a handle length of 4.14 inches or 11 centimeters. And the handle materials on this particular build are Bortok ivory scales with a zirconium pivot screw, titanium hardware, as well as blasted titanium liners, titanium 3D milled pocket clip with a ceramic ball for the contact to the scale. Then we have a zirconium, pretty large backspacer right there. And that comprises the whole handle design here. And of course, it's a liner lock. The blade runs on a bearing system. I'm not quite sure if it's actually ceramic or steel, but I would think it would be ceramic. The blade finish is an absolutely gorgeous hand rub satin finish. And the grind is actually a very nice high hollow grind, making this a neat, neat slicer with a very thin blade stock behind the edge there. Then weight-wise here on the Arcos, we're looking at 111 grams or 3.92 ounces, so a little bit heavier than an ounce, an inch mark would have you believe. And also, that's of course probably the case because of all the zirconium that is built into this knife. Other than that, it doesn't really have things that make it very heavy. Of course, there are non-skeletonized, slightly thicker titanium liners, and of course the 4 millimeter blade stock that add a bit to the weight here on the Arcos. But overall, it absolutely does not feel overly heavy in the hand. It feels very nice and balanced. Also, being a bit a thicker knife, you can see that here that we have the contoured Wartog ivory scales over the liners and the backspacer right there, and that gives you a very hand-filling feel. It feels a bit like a fixed blade in the hand, actually, in terms of the hand-filling nature of it, but also in the pocket, because of that, you will notice it more than, for example, something very slender and thin. That's certainly something you have to keep in mind. This is a bit of a more in-hand designed knife than in pocket, but I really like that here on this particular knife. I think it fits everything really, really well. And with natural scales like these, you have to go a bit thicker just to give them a bit more rigidity, to let them having some strength so they are not going to crack and things like that. So I certainly understand why he went with a bit of a thicker build here on the Arcos, and I think it's very fitting for the knife itself. Price-wise, on this particular build, we're looking at around 1,000 euros For the whole build with the Warthog Ivory, the Zirconium, RWL34, and all the things you see here on this particular build. Of course, these can be had for a bit cheaper, but of course we're talking about a handmade French custom knife, so there will be quite expensive regardless of the materials you're actually choosing. Of course, you can have pretty much anything you can think of in terms of materials. You can have a damascus steel blade, you can have zirconium as you see here, you can have zircutite, damascus, and lots of different natural materials. I think you also would go for a mammoth or something like that. So it's a true custom knife, hand built by Thierry Savidan, so you can work with the maker himself to see what specifics you would like to have on your own build. This was actually made to order by the man himself. It was a very was a big joy talking to him, working out the specifics, seeing the different finishes he had, and he really worked with me on coming up with the specifics of this build, and it was great to talk to. He also speaks very good English and is really approachable and a good guy to talk to, and very, very helpful in assisting you to get to the build that you actually have in your head. He doesn't do full customs in the term that he will build you a things that you just drawn up on a napkin. He has his specific models and you can spec them out to your likings. And I think with the designs that he offers, there is pretty much something for everybody there. And he has a very unique overall design language. I think you can certainly appreciate that by looking at the Arcos right here. Absolutely gorgeous design and pretty much very much different from everything else that you're seeing. Even if you look at the other French custom knife makers, you can spot that it's a Savidan from pretty far away, because he really has a very all-encompassing design look at things. For example, if you look at this knife close, you can't really make out how you're going to open it, because he designed the handle in a way with these nice chamfers and cutouts and the thinning out of the liners here in the top area, that the flipper tab actually integrates so well in the overall design that it almost looks like there is absolutely no way to actually open this knife. The same goes in the open position with that nice and blasted cutout here in the blade. It gives you almost the illusion that the blade starts right here, so that you only have the ground blade here and that the ricasso is actually part of the scale, because it really nicely integrates the blade portion here in the front to the overall handle. And I think this is an area where Thierry Savidan really sets himself apart from any other maker that I have experienced so far or seen work from, because the integration of the blade and the handle into one continuous flowing object is done in his models really, really impressively well. And you can see that this is an area where he actually puts a lot of interest, pride, and workmanship into it. And I think he has done that exceptionally well. I mean, in the closed position, this is an absolutely gorgeously closed form. Everything is in the right place. Nothing is not thought about. And that really, really shows here on the work by Thierry Savidan. And it's like that in all of his models. So you really can see that that is something he really thinks about quite a bit. Now let's do some size comparisons so you can get a feel for the sizing of the Arcos. We're doing our standard comparisons. We have the F95NL by Shirogorov, and then we have the Neon Zero right here. And you can see that it's almost the same size as a Neon Zero, maybe a tiny bit shorter. You get a little bit less cutting edge. But in terms of handle space, you get a bit more because of the nice sharpening choil we have here, but it's certainly smaller than an F95NL. And if we take a look at some thickness comparisons we have here, of course, it's thicker than an F95. You can certainly appreciate here the thickness that these natural and Warthog Ivory scales add to the mix, on this particular build, but also the wooden handled versions that are available of this knife have a certain thickness to them. So this is certainly a thing you have to keep in mind. This will be a bit of a thicker knife, which is great in hand, but also adds a bit of bulk in the pocket. Then we do our standard benchmark EDC blades. Here we have the Spyderco Para 3 and the full-sized Bug Out. And we can see that it's pretty much identical to a full-sized Bug Out in length. Of course, thickness and height will be different, but you can see a much more cutting edge than a Para 3, but in length, really close to a full-sized Bug Out. I think that would help most people because a Bug Out is a very ubiquitous knife in the knife community. Once again, thickness comparison with the Para 3, which is a pretty standard thickness. You can see it's certainly thicker here on the Arcos. And then some other comparisons that are probably more for the people that really dabble in these custom knives are some other French custom knives that I'm very, very fond of. Here we have the Rémy Lavial New Hardy that was custom built by Rémy for me with the clip and this gorgeous carbon fiber. Absolutely amazing piece. Also hand drop satin finish and RWL 34 in terms of steel. And then we have the formerly Dr. Franke owned GTK small spear tech. Absolutely gorgeous piece. Zirconium bolster and clip and Westinghouse micarta scales, pivot collars and backspacer. Absolutely gorgeous piece. And all of these are French front flippers, so you know I have quite a bit of a type, but you can see how distinct all these three design languages from GTK, Thierry Savidan and Rémy Lavial are. You can really spot that they went out to design something unique, and they certainly have done it here. And you also can see the integration of blade and handle is something that sets Thierry Savidan quite a bit apart from everything else that's out there. And you can also see that the Arcos here is a bit longer than both of these knives. And then one of the most popular front flippers in the world at the moment would certainly be the Gareth Bull Shamwari. This is a 3.3 inch Shamwari version. And I think this would also be a great comparison for people that like these custom front flippers and probably have or have held a Shamwari in comparison to the Thierry Savidan Arcos here. And probably the last time I will do this, again, a thickness comparison, you can certainly appreciate the difference. But in terms of length, these are very, very similar. Of course, the action on this Shamwari is flawless. Now, let's take a closer look at this knife right here. So we have an absolutely gorgeous clip point blade, hand rub satin, high hollow grind, nice swatch at the top. This very interesting blasted plate that's milled out and then blasted to give you the integral look with the end part or top part of the handle right there, which can be a bit of a gunk trap because it's actually milled out right there. But you can clean it out quite easily with some Q-tips, but it tends to accumulate a bit of a pocket lint, and if you cut things, something can also land in there and be a little bit harder to clean out, but nothing that holds the knife back in my opinion. You can also see nice and thin secondary bevel right there, very, very neatly done and sharply executed grind. Here you have a nice large forward finger choil or a sharpening choil, so you can actually grip forward, hold the knife like this and do work very, very comfortable like that. Also, this scoop here in the blade is extremely comfortable. Even if you grip back like this, that's where your thumb lands, and it's so, so comfortable. Also, because we have a 4mm blade stock right here, that certainly is much, much more comfortable than if it was thinner. And this is probably one of the most comfortable knives to hold in the hand. Very, very nicely done here on the handle design. Now, I have a small to medium hand, 7.5 sterile glove, and you can see that I fit here on this handle perfectly well. As I said, I can go into foregrip like this, really well done, and there's a lot of space left if I go in the foregrip, but also if I grip back, really, really comfortable. For that matter, here you can see the stop pin and the very fine hand ground jimping, and you can really see that this is a handmade knife. These are not perfectly spaced out, and I like to see those things on these handmade customs. You really can see that this stuff was made by hand, and I think he also doesn't have a lot of assistance by CNC mills or things like that. Like most of these French makers, they do absolutely a lot of the work by hand with very minimal tools, and that certainly shows you their knowledge and their craftsmanship. Here you can see how the flipper tab is executed, and it's very, very nicely done. So you can see perfectly centered, and the detent is very well executed. Very, very nice sound. You can see the lock up right there. Nice cutout here on the lock bar, also on the counter side right there. So very easy to disengage that lock bar. You also have a little bit of shadow boxing going on, very, very slight, but you can see that the liners are slightly raised above the Bortok ivory scale, so you can always see a bit of the liners underneath to tie everything together. Really well done. Of course, everything is very well chamfered inside and out, no sharp corners or edges. And on the inside, it actually has lasered in or engraved the date when the knife was made. Probably you can't see it, but in there it says 03/2021. So that's nice as well. You also are getting a very nice certificate of authenticity with all the information right there. And there he wrote, "Hope you will enjoy." So really, really nicely done. Also, the overall presentation is very nicely done with the package. You also get a little baggie with the Savidan logo, which, by the way, is also very, very nicely done. Here you can see the logo also. The only thing that's marked here on the blade is his logo. No steel marking or anything for that. You have to reference your certificate of authenticity you saw earlier. And overall, just an absolutely gorgeous piece. And I think he's one of the most design savvy French custom knife makers. And just the experience getting this knife from him, all the time he took to talk with me on Instagram was really appreciated by me. And I think this is one of the most beautiful knives in my collection. Love how the Wartog ivory came out. Absolutely gorgeous in contrast with the dark zirconium pivot and backspacer, this nice black and white contrast with the shiny blade right there with the hand rub satin. Gorgeous swedge also in terms of functionality, nice and thin tip, so great to poke into things, cut open ledgers, boxes and things like that. So it's also a very useful blade shape overall while being absolutely gorgeous. A thing that I have to talk about, of course, is the pocket clip. So we have a very stylized 3D milled titanium pocket clip with quite a bit of thickness to it, and it's a more of a stiffer clip than some others. We get the nice interface on the polished Wartog ivory right there, but nonetheless, this is, if you have thicker pants, this can be a bit of a stiff clip. On most of the pants that I own, it works actually quite well. Sometimes you have to lift the clip up a little bit, but other than that, it works quite well, and the carry with the clip is about like this. So a bit of the knife will be protruding. As you can see, it's attached by these two screws, so about this much will be protruding from the pocket. But on these custom knives, I don't really mind that. I think the knife itself is really well executed. The clip design wise integrates really well into the back end here of the handle. You get a very large and nicely integrated lanyard hole in the zirconium backspacer that is a pretty long backspacer, as you can see right there. And in terms of functionality, I would like to have a slightly less strong pocket clip, but the design itself is really well done. action wise is so very, very nicely done. It probably needs to be played with a slight bit more, so it's very smooth as you can see, and very controlled overall in its action. But I think if I manipulate it even a little bit more, it can get even more free falling. But I love how reproducible and strong and nice the detent is, and how well you can access it, even though you have only this tiny little thing in terms of a front flip protruding, and it's just so easy to manipulate, and that's just so well done, especially how it hides away because of the design. So that's really, really well done by Thierry Servidan on the Arcos model. And on the Xerox, the earlier front flipper model that Thierry Servidan has, that was much more pronounced. It would also very nicely integrate into the design, but the flipper tab was much longer and also could be used as an impact device. And here he really reduced it down to make it as small as possible while still being very easy to manipulate with both of your hands. And I think I can't open it with a reach around, especially not if I have to hold on to the... It actually works, but I never do that off camera. It was just to see if it goes. So you can actually open it in the reach around method, but I always open it like that because it's just more comfortable. And overall, I just wanted to show off this amazing piece by Thierry Servidan. Love how he works with natural materials, wood and Warthog ivory and so on, other bones. And I think this really sets it apart from other knives in the collection. I really love these natural materials. And I think Thierry Servidan has done an amazing job here on the Arcos. And I think this is my absolute favorite model from him. And I'm very happy that I could get this in my collection. So I think he doesn't run books in the traditional sense, but you can contact him on Instagram or on Facebook. You will find all the links in the description below, and maybe he can work something out. You have probably to wait a couple of months or even half a year, but in the end he will be able to make you something, as far as I understand. So I would not hesitate to contact him to see if you can get a amazing knife from him, because I think he certainly deserves to be in the tier of French knife makers that he is in. I think all these knives are in the same kind of realm for French custom knife makers, and they are all in their own right very, very special. But in terms of design, I think Thierry Servidan really has a unique place in the custom knife makers of France. And that's also why I love to have a piece of him in my collection. So thanks again for watching. I hope you liked it. If you did so, please give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions, put them down in the comments below. Check out the unboxing if you haven't so already. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram at 7ready_knife_reviews to see more pictures and more insight about these custom knives and also some production knives in my collection. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day and goodbye.